Welcome back to the Generation Y. You're with me, Scott Sunjata Keita. We are talking about the film industry in Kenya. Is there a future? Where are we going? And where have we been? Remember to join the conversation. You can go to our Facebook page, our Twitter handle, and keep the conversation going. Now, Tosh, looking at the film industry, of course, there's a lot that the government needs to do to just push the industry and make it profitable for actors and also for the entertainment industry itself. But what are those kind of solutions that you've seen working in, say, Hollywood or even other international industries that you would want to be applied here?
I mean, we don't even need to go far. Mm-hmm. First and foremost, we need to take this industry seriously. Mm-hmm. I feel that, you know, like questions I get, you're going to shoot, take a picture for a whole day, you know, there's a lack of seriousness.
So it seemed like a game or something, like
you know, a hobby. Mm-hmm. Let's use the word hobby. Mm-hmm. There's a lack of a seriousness that's taken this industry. Mm-hmm. First, that needs to change. Mm-hmm. Secondly, we just need to adapt what South Africa is doing.
Yeah.
Simple. Mm-hmm. South Africa has created an environment for themselves to attract a lot of foreign productions that bring in a lot of income. Mm-hmm. Then part of that income is used to help the local local industry by forming a national, we have the Kenya Film Commission. Mm-hmm. So if you make the environment better to bring in foreign productions that spend a lot of money here and then inject money to this film commissions to, you know, give out to filmmakers to start making films, even whatever small, short, you know, start filling the airwaves and online with local films, then the industry should start changing.
Exactly. And, you know, the Youth Enterprise Development Fund recently piloted a program where they call it Tech 254. It's kind of like a loan for film industry, film producers and everything. And also, like, you know, Machakos County is doing some projects for them.
Yes.
Do you think that these kinds of agendas, are they really beneficial or are they just...
I mean, they can be. I'm not so sure about loaning yet. Mm-hmm. But I feel the industry needs to be built up first, you know, so that even if you give a loan to someone, they can be able to pay it back.
Exactly.
Because that's what it is, a loan.
Yeah.
No point of giving a young filmmaker money, he cannot be
then
able
they
to
can't
return.
So
I like what Machakos is doing, small competitions, he wins some money, go and make another film.
Yeah.
You know, if all counties took that up, you know, suddenly we're going to have an influx of actors, camera people,
directors,
you know,
and everything.
And suddenly, competition, I believe in competition, you know. So when counties start competing against each other, you only endeavor to be better than you were, you know.
Exactly.
But if there's no competition, you're okay with, you know, the usual. You
don't
push yourself.
And the challenge of piracy, especially in the film industry, how can, say, any film producer, how do you guys navigate around that?
That one is still very difficult. You know, it's difficult to deal with. Distribution is a problem here. I mean, you only have a few cinemas. People want to see the film. In fact, the biggest problem for piracy here is not even because of the amount of money, but because of availability. People want to see something. The easiest way they get it is
through
piracy. So it's still a big monkey on our backs that hopefully in time we'll be able to tackle.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, as we just a parting shot, as we finish up our show, like that one thing that you'd want youths out there in the film industry to change about themselves?
It's simple. You know, put the hard work into it.
Yeah.
There's a lot of perception that this the creatives is about talent. Get that out of your head.
It's not about talent.
No. Actually, you have to work the hardest than in any other profession, I believe. You know, some professions you only go to work from 8 to 5. You can shut your mind until tomorrow. In filming,
keep it active.
There's nothing like that. So hard work.
Hard work.
You know, it's what I keep saying, is what I feel that is our biggest issue or problem. Misconception, especially amongst the youth. I've seen youth come to my office, and at five they want to go home, you know, when in the middle of a production.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, it doesn't work that way. You have to put in more time, more passion, and, you know, more hard work.
Mm-hmm.
That's the perception of that it's a talent should get out of your head.
Exactly. Amazing stuff. Well, there you've had it yourself, hard work, and that's all the time we could have for here. Tosh, thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you.
It was such an honor.
My pleasure.
Well, remember again to join the conversation, keep it alive on our Facebook page, on our Twitter handle, and of course, we'll always get back to you. You've been watching The Generation Y with me, Scott Sinjata-Keita. See you next time.